Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will continue exploring the collision detection feature of RoboDK. Let's get started. For this example, let's start with the 07B collision laser cutting. So if I bring this one up, this one is a station using a Fennec robot. We are picking plastic parts here. We have kind of a laser cutter here. We're using a method called robot holds object or fixed TCP or remote TCP, where the object is attached to the robot tool and then the active tool is actually remote or fixed in the station. So we are bringing the part to the tool instead of bringing the tool to the part with the tool attached to the robot. So we'll discuss that in a future module, if I'm not mistaken, module 12 or something like that. But for now, we'll just use this station as an example for the collision checking option. So first of all, I will start by making the laser cutting cell invisible so that it's easier for us to work. And I will activate my collision checking option here. So as you can see here, I already have a collision detected between the tool and the robot. So as I explained in the last video, this is something that might need to be addressed or kind of fixed within the collision map. I need to tell RoboDK which objects are kind of assembled together. It can't just guess it. So in this case here, I will take a look at where the collision occur. So I see here, I have my hair cup tool. By the way, those are kind of hair cup protection for wrestler. And it's colliding with J6, which is my robot flange. So I don't want to check collision between the tool and the flange, as those will for sure be attached or assembled together. So I just have to double click on it to remove some of the collision checking here. Another thing here, you see we have an option here called include hidden object. So remember I just hide my protection, or in fact my station here, my enclosure before. So if I hide my enclosure and I don't change the default value, I can move everywhere like that. But here in theory, I should have a collision here and a collision here. But if I go here and I, in my collision map, and I select include hidden object, hide this one, I make my enclosure invisible, and then I move forward. Even if this isn't showing, it will show me as soon as I have a collision with the enclosure. So that's super useful. You can use it in many ways. You can use it in the way I'm using it here to not have to have the enclosure visible at all time, which can be useful if you want to work within the enclosure or something like that. If the object you're trying to work with is kind of in your face or in your way to program, but you still want to be able to verify collision with it. And it can also be useful if you want to create kind of zones, so protection zone, but you don't want to see those protection zone all the time. So you can just create those zones and then you hide them, but you still verify for collision with those zones. I'm gonna bring that back, make that visible again here. Little trick here, you can see that I'm able to kind of select things through the object here. So this is a small trick, tips I'm gonna give you right now. If you have a color and if you click on the color, so remember I already showed you how to change the color, and if the alpha channel is under 125, so the alpha channel goes from 0 to 255, which is kind of 0 to full, from completely transparent to fully opaque, anything below 125 will kind of be unselectable, or you'll be able to select things through it. It might create some weird behavior in terms of what kind of shows and doesn't show, but it's a cool trick if you want to create some windows like I just did here. Okay, so now let's start with, we have the collision checking option activated, and let's run the main program. So here the program is already created for you. You just have to run it and kind of fix the different problems you will find in terms of collision checking. So if I go main program, right away here, we have a collision between the tool and the window. So this occurs because I have a target somewhere here, an approach target to go pick those here piece that isn't positioned properly. So if I go in my in frame here and I go and I make this one here, my approach position is right here. So that doesn't make any sense. I'm gonna move that somewhere here, maybe a bit backward like that. And I will, first of all, I can't just reclick on main because I'm kind of stuck right now in my collision. So I'm gonna double click on the home position. I'm gonna click on main. And then I can move forward and I kind of fixed that first issue. Now you can see we have another issue here where RoboDK detects a collision between the piece I want to pick and the tool. So again, this is the kind of collision that is, I would say, normal. I'm going to press plus a few times to see my TCP. So I need to tell RoboDK that it's fine to have a collision between this and that, because otherwise I can't pick that. And I will also kind of speed up the process. I will automatically create or voluntarily create a collision between all of those objects, because if I go here and then collision map, I will see all the objects that are currently colliding, and I will be able to select here uncheck collided. So this way all the objects that were in a collision state were transformed into objects that are not looked for in terms of collision. Perfect here. So I will be able to go back to home and do main again. Oops. Yep. I need to do replace object first. Otherwise, I will pick two objects. So replace object here will replace all the objects. I don't have a replace object here at the beginning of my main program. I should have added that. So that's a rookie mistake. And then here I'm following the path with my remote TCP situation. You will see that if you are looking, so I did that kind of on purpose, if you're checking for collision, stuff might go a bit slower. So if I do that, you will see that things are a bit slower, kind of laggy a bit. Collision checking is really power hungry. It's, yeah, you need to verify a lot of polygons at all times. So you might want to kind of use it when you need to use it, and uncheck it or deactivate it when you don't need it. Otherwise, your computer might have a hard time. Mine is relatively powerful. I have a top-end computer from 2019. It's not top-end anymore, but still very capable. So yeah. So here we just fixed most of the problem we had with this one. I think all the problem we had. I want to show you two other things here. So if you go to Tools Options, you will see under Motion, you have collision checking, maximum pad step in millimeters and maximum pad step in degrees. So by default, RoboDK won't check for collision at every, let's say, 0.00 millimeter. Otherwise, it would be like almost unusable considering how much computing power collision checking requires. So it's checking for collision at either the maximum of those two values, either if the TCP moves 4 millimeters or if any of the joints move 4 degrees or more. You can make that lower. So if you feel like there's some collision somewhere that you should have been detected, but it wasn't, it might be because it was kind of just in between 2 4-millimeters step. So making it like 1 millimeter is, should be good enough for most, let's say, capable computer. But the other solution you have is also just to use here your slider and verify some section that you feel are a bit more risky, or you're going close to another object, and then you can just look with your eyes to see if there is no red appearing on your screen, which would be the way RoboDK would show you that there's a collision at that point. Okay, last information, if you bring here 07C collision vision cone, perfect. There's one thing that can be a bit annoying if I activate the collision checking like that here. Here, this is just a vision cone, a cone of vision, or that I created to show or to be able to know where the camera or what the camera will actually see so that I can create my targets accordingly. But if I come here, you will see that now with the collision checking, it kind of detects a collision between the vision cone and the actual part, which wouldn't happen in real life, because like it's not a physical thing, it's just a representation. Same goes if you were to create a paint spray, where to see where you're applying the paint. It's not something physical, and you kind of want to have a collision between your part and that. So that means that you are actively working on the part. So what I do in this case is I would create, I will kind of separate the tool from the vision cone. So this way I can go in my collision map and I can just say here, the camera view shouldn't be verified, or you shouldn't check for collision with the camera view in any case. So now here the camera view is fully free of running through the part, but as soon as I have a collision between the actual tool and the part, now it's stopping me. So that's pretty much everything for this video and this topic. I hope you find it helpful. I do believe that collision checking is very important for most robotic application. It will save you a lot of time and risk and potentially dollars. So always a good thing to do a small collision checking before launching a project or before loading the project directly on the robot. In the next video, we will talk about Euler angles. So how RoboDK represent our orientation or rotation in a 3D environment, and how this translates to a real robot program and the different robot brands we have to deal with. So in any case, have a great day, guys.